in my opinion. Anyways, this guy. I want split, range, and empowered. So actually, let's take that off, though. It doesn't matter like what it is, really, because I'm not going to do buffs. So empowered. Oh wait, no, I want... I'd like range, because I want to do duet, I think. But the slow is good as well. And if I go health on them... I didn't put it in my deck. I get dumb. Like, how much range would I really need with health on them? Because, like, these aren't really the widest lanes. Empowered. What does duet look like? Lower damage of it. I mean, that's kind of just what, like, the difference is between an orb and, like, a medallion or merc, right? But I think I get what you're saying. Really play into it. But I have to, like, take in speed scaling. But it's kind of how that stuff works. Okay. So, like, I would put two per lane. So I could try to freeze as many enemies as possible. I mean, it's really just like a cannonball takedown with occasional freezing. The extra slow would be nice, but they're at 58.5 right now. Do I have a range ready to go? I got a rate ready to go. As much as I don't need it. For this setup. Sharpened spikes. None of these are range, right? Who has them? Oh, my sand traps that I'm not gonna use has one on it. Let's do that. What else? Skyguard, flame. Do I have three or four now? You have one. And you have one. I'm not gonna use flamethrowers right now, so let's take that out. So, the slow is okay. And then let's grab the cannonballs. And we'll go... We'll do this. So, it'll be... Like, a lot of cannonballs go on range. Heavy cannonballs all the time. And hopefully a bunch of freezes, I guess, is the idea. Yeah, that's good range. Okay, that's the range I want. I'm just a little worried about putting, like, these cannonballs behind a wall like this. Because of javelin tossers. Like, I really need the heavies going. Yo, iHop's just doing something dumb, because I can, I guess, is what I'm doing. This is a bad spot for it. This is actually kind of, like, not the lane I want to do it. Alright, let's take it to the extreme of that corner. On the light, I think I can still see up the lane. And, like, they should go over the wall, too. Right? And they're still, like, okay DPS. Why don't I get a bunch of them going? You hope they're good again? I mean, I'd love them to be good again. And they might actually be pretty decent right now. Let's do it backwards, maybe. Can I show you one? I mean, I could try, but last time I did it, I failed hard. Holy frick. I think Juice uses them pretty effectively, and honestly, I'd probably build them the same as I build my Flame Auras. No range, rate, and power transfer on a medallion. But I can try it for sure. I just don't think I'm gonna do it today. I don't have like the placement down for using them in C5. I can feel like there's something I'm missing in my headspace regarding it. Or maybe I should try to do. Like, can I do this and this? Bring the wall up. Is that too close to the gate? Can I wall that off effectively like that? I don't think I can. But if I do this, and I do maybe like three cannonballs over here. Get like left and right. And then I'll stick one behind the wall here for berserks and stuff. Specifically in case those ones don't focus the berserks down. This might work. Oh, jeez. Those shoot up enough, right, to hit the flyers, like before imminent doom. And I'll probably. I might stick a sky goat over here too. We'll see how the DU works out. I'd like the slow on them, but I don't know if I need it. Here's the troubling lane. I'm not necessarily gonna gate kill it, I just wanna see how the DU works out doing it like that. That one and this one, actually. This one isn't too bad. You can get weird like this. Not really the best map for this. I need, like, ideally you'd want, like, long straight lanes for it, right? For something like I'm trying to do. But I've seen them roll, like, down that hole and up. So I think I can do this. And then a couple over here as well. My only worry with this setup, and actually I can move that back a little bit. How far do those go? All the way to the stairs? Perfect. Originally, I put it far up because I thought I was gonna put the Frosties up on like the ledge there. I can try this. That just leaves this lane. I think I have the DU for it. It's just, where am I gonna put the Frosty Towers? Like, even with their range, they still have to go alongside the lane, so it's kind of risky. I put stuff here before and it's been fine. So what if I do like here and maybe on here? Is it for DPS or CC? It's for both, I guess. So this doesn't give me any like Skyguard support, but it's something. Is there anywhere I feel like I need a second wall? Probably going for the Dryad. Dryad's fun, yeah. That's double Frosty per lane, four cannonballs. I'm not sold. Because it's like cannonball DPS, but there's not a whole lot of DPS on the single target cannonballs. But I'm hoping, you know, the heavies and those crits and get a few shatters in there and stuff as well. I'm rocking an orb, yeah. I'm rocking an orb with rate, heavy cannonball, and range. I don't like this lane, how it is. Could I do it the other way? That's probably for the best. Let me redo this one. Face it this part here, and I can feel a little safer with the cannonballs. I'll do a little something like this, maybe. Nah. Yeah. Let's try it. And then just to be like, well, actually, it's probably better just to do it only on this side. And I might use my last 30 to wall here. A second one. I have tried dummy malls yet. They seem fine. I just like the thickness of the squire walls. They thick, you know? I'll get him a bit on there, but hopefully it'll focus on the ones on the path here. They thick, yo. Maybe this is excessive, I don't know. Especially like this. Do I feel confident in this setup? Not really. I'm actually also thinking of putting like a Frosty Tower here in case they get around, because it's kind of an awkward turn. So let me do that instead. I know technically this isn't the start of the stream, but I might be starting the stream off with a loss here. Honestly, like, if this works, I shouldn't have build up on the walls. I don't know if I really need to, like, plug that hole perfectly. Just as thick? I don't know about that. I think they are a little less thick, but, like, it's pretty close, and I don't know if their attack speed's faster, right? Like, these are 0.75 attack rate. That's pretty fast. It's the start of the stream for you. Oh, God. Starting off with a loss. Almost certainly. I can't remember if they, like, will walk around that or not. Like that. We'll see. Let's put it in the middle of the purple line and pray. I think the rest are good. Oh, fuck, I didn't build this yet. 5 hits per second at 0.2 attack rate. That's what you're saying, really? I mean, that's good, for sure. Why am I not using them? I'm probably not using them because, like, it actually takes work to get them up that fast. Which isn't, like, a great reason for anything, but whatever. That's a big lane. Let me buff that one, especially since I'm kind of concerned about the wall. If I'm gonna win or lose, it's not gonna be based off these initial upgrades, I don't think. No, I should be squiring. Get him! Shatters? The shatter? That was a shatter, right? Or did he just die normally? Yeah, that was a shatter. I was gonna say build up over there, but it's not really build up, that's just how the frost towers work. Here's the... Okay, yeah. As long as they're not, like, in the pack, I probably will be fine. And if that thing rages, it's probably gonna rage on the, on my totem frost towers, right? Yeah, plenty can charge them. The thing is, like, can you charge a whole Nimbus map to be ready in time? I kind of just like my guaranteed spike blockades, but I don't think it's bad or anything to grind. Like, keep rocking it, dude. That's awesome. But I have played with them. It's just my preference not to, but if there's ever any, you know, fun builds or anything I want to do, I'm more than willing to use them again. Not gonna upgrade those bad boys. Let's do these, since I'm not over here. They're low. If he stomps, he's probably gonna hit those. So I'll have, if I want to be over here, I'll have to be, like, in this range. If he stomps, the Frosties are fine. I'll just repair them. Well, that's the great thing about the game, the grind. There's many different ways to play, and everything's just great. So you can play with your dummy walls, I'll play with my spike blockades, and someone else is gonna go do their orb mystic walls and have success as well. And that's one of the things I love about this game right now. So let's see how much I can bung this up. I'm afraid like if I stand around here, I'm just gonna assassin bop these things and all that. You know what, at 4 of them at 370k, it is more than 370k because the heavies can crit, it's probably fine against an ogre. Man, the Frosty Towers aren't having a chance to do anything. I need hefty bosses or something. Actually, can you even freeze bosses and shatter them? I don't think they can shatter. There we go, that's what we need. Yeah! They crit just as much as anything else. Or are you saying, like, the amount they crit for? Let's see if we can watch a crit. I think... It's not, like, you know, huge. And I think shards have their own crit scaling, but they do crit. And it's pretty decent, from what I can tell. Enough for me to think like these things are doing about 400k. Like, I'm rounding up to 400k on this right now, off heavy crit, not like a ton. 260, then it'd be more. Basically, 30% of that added on. Then at how frequently it does it, but then the, you know, you factor in the whole penetration part. So, what's their proc chance, and then their frequency? 23, 36. Let's do some smart upgrading. Too much math. Okay, well, that was the point, right? I was saying, you know, let's just say they're 400k. Fuck the math. This is just decent. Target's chilled, 29, 17. The rich get richer, 39 and 23, so you and you. 38. Don't do this to me, game. How do I decide? You. You get 3 kills now. I was gonna say, you do it. You're a special case. Alright, we got a roller. I wonder if this will be enough. Just as stun though? Like, do you stun instead of heavy cannonball? Normally my cannonballs are defense rate heavy cannonball and power chancer, because I actually really like the damage from them too. And I don't need them hitting whole lanes, but deadly strikes is great. Putting a stun on there instead of deadly strikes or anything else is fine too. There's so many ways to do them. It gets me giddy just thinking, like, just talking about it. You only use one of them. Well, I mean, this isn't my regular build, right? I do two heavies per lane, typically. One or two, depending on how many flame auras I build. I'm curious if those will take down the roller on its own. Oh, the shatters. It's so good. Yeah, 264 crits. Oh, I was wondering where these guys went. Here, I got stunned there. I got CC thinged. Oh, one ported away. So when he rounds the corner, he should be taking damage, and I think heavy cannonballs will go through and hit him. Not a lot, but a decent bit. Yeah, look at this. The dream. This is the dream. Woo! The dream. Alright, hey man, what up? Yo, not much, dude. New player, looking forward to endgame. I've heard different opinions. Is it worth gearing multiple characters or one, then pass gear down as you replace? Well, I mean, if you're new, like just starting now, make sure you have one of each of the campaign characters, or the regular characters, and go through campaign with all of them. I'm not positive of what you mean, like through progression and stuff, and passing gear down. You may be getting different answers based on, like, different people's interpretations of what you're saying. Because, like, there's weird things going on with gearing right now and, like, different ways to do it efficiently. Kind of thing that say, like, hey, you want to do one hero at once or whatever. But that doesn't mean, like, you should completely avoid the other characters either. It just means about combat phases. And I think that might be a bit of what's going on here. Oh, I'm never single-walling that lane, the grind. I've been burned too much in the past. It's like pre-trials. You know what? If a kobold kills me 150 maps, that's enough for me to put a wall in. The walls are only 20 DU then. I've been burned by them before. But yeah, so... like, finish the campaign, gear up, do all that, and that's fine. You know, stack relics on the defenses you want out of all those heroes, build up. But after you start, like, you get your 50 gear from playing Harbinger's Worship a bunch of times, then you gear up. And then when you're going into, like, Chaos and stuff, during combat phases, I think is what people are saying, you'd only want the one hero in your deck. Oh, you're Ascension 32. Sorry, I didn't see the Ascension part. So, my bad. All for the beginning to 50, it just seems easier to gear one person than four. Yeah, so that's the thing, right? What it is like, gear drops based on what's in your deck. So you want things to have all, like, full upgraded armor. But if you only do the one DPS hero, you only have to worry about one for getting, like, armor relics progressing. You don't have to get, like, four times as much loot, right? To progress to each stage, as long as you have your one reliable DPS that you use during combat. So, it's less loot you gotta look for, and you're not gonna get bogged down by other heroes in your deck having worse loot that'll lower your drops. Do relics matter for gear gating? Not as far as I know. Because the others are tower based. Yeah, so like, that's why I took, you probably weren't here, but these were my builders, and I had this guy in my deck as well during build phase, but because he has no armor, he's gonna bring down my overall drops during combat if I had him in my deck. So that's why people do it. They'll take out anything that's not well armored. And really early on, the most efficient way to do that is just having the one hero. Doesn't mean you can't do multiple, but it's just easier. Less loot you need, yeah. Why do I have a ping? Oh, no, I'm good. Is it pointless in Gary them? If all they're doing, I mean, here's like, you know, your towers are your towers, your DPS are your DPS, and it's separate in this game. But putting armor on them isn't really necessary. As long as you don't have them in your deck during combat, you don't need to armor them up, yeah. I've been doing it now since I'm at the end of the current iteration of the game, but as you do progression, and even then, you still don't need to. Just the ones you want to DPS with. What are the bosses? Fiddly, like the same setup as last wave? Yeah. If all they do is build, don't put armor on them. But you do want one hero, like, for DPSing fully armored as well. That's how you'll get your drops. No, it must have been the kobold. But I only lost the one. Oh no, I thought it'd be this lane. Oh, it's you? I fucked up. I forgot about the geode. I've been playing with Aura so much that I forgot about it. BGW4, thanks for the follow. Alright, I want to get out of there. I want to get out of here. But actually, you know, I can just stand here. It's fine. I'll be fine. I just don't want my towers to get hit by the roller rockets. But all the bosses should go down. I already saw the roller get taken down last wave, so I'm pretty confident in that lane. That's my problem with this iteration of the game. No defense elf on anything? Or I'm not doing defense elf on anything? So what happened here? Flyers, he was not taking a lot of damage. It's probably maybe because he's a Quibbly, he doesn't need to go as far. These guys were attacking flyers and not killing them very quickly. It worked. And it's not like I have to refine this build too much. But I'm curious to why that happened. Alright, where's the geode? Trendy also, can we please remove geodes finally? From C5, you know, as intended. Alright, this time we got Quibbles. Tuskar and a roller again. Could be bad luck. That's the thing, the grind. Like, four cannonballs with 0.75 attack rate. The crits are happening. And I guess, like, that's the thing. Like, it's not really bad luck. I just took a few hits onto my wall. So. It's not all that bad. I think it was just a mix of a late flyer lane with a ranged Quibbly. Doing some awkward combinations of tower aggro. Man, am I getting a roller and a Quibbly every wave? That's real weird. What I should have done is like buff this guy, because he's the boss taker downer. Maybe Quibbly was like sitting up here or something. Alright, so geodes here. Yeah, you know, I'll just use you to take it out. No! I can't be stunlocked here! Freaking assassins. What's great about this build is I don't have to care about assassins at all. Four heavy cannonballs per lane. Shit's getting knocked off me almost immediately. as so. Yeah, he was able to like sit up there, so it was, I'm guessing it was just that. Is Tuskar already dead? Distracted towers, getting distracted on things and distractions. Oh, no AP. Yeah, it looks like it's just weird cannonball aggro. Maybe they are like a beam. Don't lose target that easily. No. All characters, yeah, all characters are viable in endgame for sure. Some defenses are more or less viable depending on which chaos tier you're in, though. And in turn, like, you know, certain DPSs as well. But overall, like, yeah, you can use all of them. But, like, ranged heroes aren't great in, like, C3 and 4. But, I mean, this really is around it and stuff. And they all have parts of the kit that can deal with it. Yeah. Abyss Lord and Pyro. When you say Pyro, do you mean Lavamancer? Meteor Rain. Do I have that? I can check now. Thank you, Trendy. Meteor Rain. I do have a Meteor Rain, so let's get rid of you. I don't need to. But yeah, I mean, really, as a general statement, yeah, they're all viable. They've all got stuff that's pretty strong on them.